गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आहाटी वेलकम टू यू इन योर एसएसटी क्लास। एज यू नो चिल्ड्रन, इन अवर प्रीवियस ट्यूटोरियल वी कवर्ड द टॉपिक थिंग्स दैट मेक अप आवर वेदर, एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक फैक्टर्स इन्फ्लुएंसिंग क्लाइमेट। बट बिफोर मूविंग अहेड लेट्स रिकैप। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, Which are the components of weather? As we know, weather is made up of lots of components like sunshine, clouds, wind, rain, thunderstorm, freezing rain, sleet, hail, heat waves, excessive heat, blizzards, and lot of things. Many more. Okay. Do you know, student, what is hail? Hail means small balls of ice that fall from the sky like rain. Okay. And what is sleet? Sleet is a mixture of rain and snow. Okay, sleet is a mixture of rain and snow. And what is blizzards? Blizzard is a very bad storm with strong winds and lots of snow. Okay. Excessive heat means unbearable heat. Okay, very much hot. So let's watch a video related to warm fronts and cold fronts.
Day off. I can't believe there was a snowstorm. It just came out of nowhere. The snow didn't just come from nowhere. A cold front moved in.
A what?
A cold front. A front is the boundary where two air masses clash, and weather, like snow, occurs. There are warm and cold fronts. I'll demonstrate.
No, don't! Just tell me.
I'm not gonna throw it at you. Listen, you know what an air mass is, right?
A big, massive blob of air?
Kinda. An air mass is a large body of air that has the same temperature and moisture level throughout. There are four different types of air masses in the United States, and each one carries its own temperature and amount of moisture.
So, what are their names?
Well, two are cold and two are warm. The two cold air masses are the Maritime Polar Air Mass and the Continental Polar Air Mass.
What about the two warm air masses?
The two warm air masses are called the Maritime Tropical Air Mass and the Continental Tropical Air Mass.
So which ones can I thank for the snow day?
It snowed because one of the cold air masses clashed with a warm one and made a cold front. When that snowball hit you, it exploded, right?
Yeah, and it hurt.
Well, Sam, I think it's instant replay time. Let's say the snowball was a cold air mass, and you were a warm air mass. When you both clashed together, a front was made, and the ball burst. It snowed.
Oh, that's kind of cool.
Yeah, this snowstorm is a result of a cold front. Cold fronts happen when a cold air mass pushes a warm air mass up. Big, puffy clouds, called cumulus clouds, are formed. When you see dark clouds like those, you can bet you're in for some heavy rain, thunderstorms, or a snowstorm like this.
What happens at a warm front?
A warm front happens when a warm air mass catches up with a cold air mass and slowly climbs up and over it. As the warm air mass passes over the cold air, long, thin, stratus clouds stretch out across the sky. A warm front can cause rain and snow too, but it's light and steady, not heavy and stormy like a cold front's weather.
So, a cold front means pretty crazy weather that gets me a snow day. And a warm front just means it might still rain or snow, but it won't be as intense. An air mass is a large body of air that has the same temperature and moisture throughout, and there are four types of air masses in the U.S. Each one has unique characteristics that hint at where it formed. When two of these air masses meet, they form a boundary called a front. It can be a warm front or a cold front, but either way, some kind of weather always happens on a front.
Hey! Okay, I deserved it. It's freezing, though. I think I'm gonna head in for some hot chocolate.
Start from here. Climate is the average weather in a location over a long period of time. What is climate, students? It is the average weather in a location over a long period of time. And what is weather? Weather is day-to-day experience. Okay. A place that does not get much rain over many years would have a dry climate. Suppose a place we does not get rain for many years. Okay. वहाँ बारिश ही नहीं होती. So its climate will be counted as a dry climate. Okay. And another place where it stay cold for most of the year, और एक ऐसी जगह जहाँ पर बहुत सालों तक ठंड पड़ती है. So its climate will be counted as cold climate. Okay, students. Climate is useful for weather forecasting. Weather forecasting means, weather forecasting is the prediction of the atmosphere in a particular place by using technology and scientific knowledge. Okay. It also determines means decides. It also determines when the best time would be for farmers to plant their crops. Means, at what time the farmer should plant their crops. It also determines. Okay. What determines? Who determines? Weather forecasting. Through the weather forecasting, we can know about the best time for farmers to plant their crops. It could even be helpful for you and your family to plan a vacation. Okay. So, by watching weather forecasting, you can also plan a vacation. Okay. In other words, look out your window anytime and you see weather. आप अपनी विंडो से बाहर देखो और आप देख सकते हो कि कैसा वेदर है. ठीक है. हाउ इज़ द वेदर टुडे. लुक आउट फ्रॉम योर विंडो एवरी डे फॉर अ मंथ और लॉन्गर. ओके. इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन यू कि आप कितने टाइम तक ऑब्जर्व करते हैं. सो यू कैन ऑल्सो ऑब्जर्व फॉर अ मंथ और अ लॉन्गर और लॉन्गर. ऑब्जर्व द वेदर ईच डे एंड यू कैन डिटरमाइन द क्लाइमेट. सो after observing many months or years, so you can also determine the climate. Okay, students. Now come to the another topic, that is factors influencing climate. Okay. So there are too many factors which influence the climate of a place. The very first factor is distance from the equator. Okay, then we will read altitude, then distance from the sea and direction of the winds and mountain barriers. Okay, so all these things are included in influencing the climate of a place. So let's start with the first factor, that is distance from the equator. The sun shines vertically over the equator throughout the year. Vertically means like this. Okay. This one. The sun shines vertically over the equator throughout the year. Throughout the year means for whole year. Okay. So, the rays of the sun fall directly on the equator. Vertically means directly on the equator throughout the year. You can see in the picture the equator direct rays. Okay. Getting student? This is the equator and there are rays of the sun. So, they are falling directly or vertically. Okay, over the equator. Therefore, it is very hot near the equator. As we move away from the equator towards the poles, the sun's rays fall slantingly and they provide less heat. It means, as you can see in the picture, it's very hot. If sun rays are fall directly on the equator, so this area receives too much heat, okay, throughout the year. But as we move away from the equator towards the poles, the sun's rays fall slantingly. Slantingly means sloping, okay, and they provide less heat. Okay, they do not fall directly, they fall slantingly and they provide less heat, less than the equator. Therefore, temperature away from the equator decreases with the increase in latitude. Okay, with the increasing of latitudes, the temperature decreases. Okay, on the basis of temperature, three heat zones are found on the globe. How many heat zones are there? There are three heat zones found on the globe. These are, first is torrid or hot zone between the equator and the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. Okay, now you can see here the rays are slanting. Okay, they do not fall directly as they fall directly on the equator. Second is temperate or moderate zone between the tropics and Arctic and Antarctic circle. Second heat zone is temperate or moderate zone, neither very hot neither nor very cold. Temperate means na bahut jyada garmi aur na bahut jyada sardi. So this zone between the tropics, tropics means Tropic of Cancer or Tropic of Capricorn, and between the Arctic and Antarctic circle. Okay, it means 23.5 degrees north to 66.5 degrees north and 23.5 degrees south to 66.5 degrees south. Okay, these two zones, these two areas come under temperate zone. Okay, student. And third type zone is the frigid or cold zone. Frigid or cold zone between the Arctic and the Antarctic circle and the poles. Okay. Means between 66.5 degrees north to 90 degrees north and 66.5 degrees south to 90 degrees south pole. Okay, this in all three heat zones are observed on the globes. Okay, students. So how many heat zones are there? There are three heat zones. Which three heat zones? Torrid zone, temperate zone, and frigid zone. Okay, so I'm ending here the chapter. Rest of the chapter we will read in our next tutorial. Okay, now note down the homework. Students, it's your homework beta. Read chapter 6 and do question number 1 and 2 in your rough notebook. These are short question answers. Okay, once again I am repeating, read chapter 6 and do question number 1 and 2 in your rough notebook. Okay, have a nice day. Goodbye.